right, map crew, we're getting ready to explore the world of color blocking on Project Sketch here on Map TV. Boop. All right, map crew, for this project, here's what you're gonna need. Piece of paper, a ruler, pencil, and markers. If you don't have them, what are you doing? Get them, pause the video, now. Just pause it. Okay, guys, you might be sitting down with your art tools in front of you, but before we get to the project, I'm gonna put an image up on your screen. Here's what I want you to do. With your friends, family, who's ever around you, your parents, I want you guys to take a minute. You're gonna look at the image that's on your screen, and all I want you to do is observe it. Just look at it, and write down what you see. There's not necessarily a hidden picture or anything like that. Just simply write down what you see. Image up now. Okay, guys, take a good look at it. Tell me what you see. All right, write down, discuss. Write down everything you see in the image. Keep going. I know there's more. Keep looking. Think about it. Look at the image. Think about it. Think about it. Keep writing. Keep writing and looking. Writing and looking. Writing and looking. About 10 more seconds. 10 more seconds. And we're done. Perfect. All right, map crew. Now, we looked at that image. Let's go ahead. No, now, don't all share at once or shout. We're going to make a list of some of the things we observed. Some of the things you looked at in that painting. All right, guys, not all at once. I can't take it. Let's go ahead. Let's write up on our trusty whiteboard right here. Okay, go ahead and start sharing at home. Oh, yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one?
Yeah.
Lines. Saw lines there. Okay, perfect. Lines. What else? Okay, somebody said colors.
Colors.
Okay. Yeah, there were, okay, colors. Yeah, red. Okay, let's put that. Red. You said blue? Okay. Blue. And, yeah, yellow.
Correct.
Okay. What else did we see when looking at that? Okay, somebody said shapes. Shapes, you saw shapes. Okay, perfect. What else? Oh, okay, like white. White, you saw a lot of white squares. White squares. Okay. What else did you guys see? Okay, like somebody put empty spaces. So those white squares were kind of like empty spaces. Okay. Let's see, and somebody said more white squares than colored squares. All right, cool. Now, yeah, that's a good one. So you said not just shapes, but it was squares and rectangles. All right, squares and rectangles, very good. All right, so there's a lot here. Is there anything else we saw? Anything else? All right, yeah. Okay, not just lines, but what color were the lines? You said black, right? Black. Was there anything else? That's correct. Those lines weren't just black, but they were like thick black lines, okay? So I'm gonna write thick right here. Perfect, I mean, this is a lot. This is a big list. Let's go over it. We have lines that were thick and black. We had colors, red, blue, yellow. What were they? Somebody said it at home, primary colors. So primary colors, we have shapes that are squares, rectangles, white squares, empty spaces. What else? Was there anything else? Was I leaving anything out? Hey, that's pretty good. You said the lines? I'm gonna write that down here. I don't have much space up there. You see the lines went vertical and horizontal, just up and down or side to side. So vertical, up and down, or side to side. That's right, that's right. Whew! That's one big list for one very simple piece of art. Let's go ahead and talk about the piece of art we saw and what it was and who did it. All right, the artwork that you saw earlier, well, let's go ahead and put that image back on the screen. Boop. This was a piece of artwork done by the artist named Piet Mondrian. Piet Mondrian. What did he do? Well, he was the father of color blocking. That was his art technique. Color blocking. What is color blocking? Well, it's basically what it says. Color blocking. It's taking colors, dividing them up on a canvas or paper or whatever you want to paint on, color on, so you could see the colors distinctly apart. Color blocking. Just what it says, color blocking. Now, let me show you some other compositions by the artist Piet Mondrian. Boop. So if we take a look at some of his other compositions, we see that they're the same, very similar, same technique, rhyme and reason, but yet in a way, they're very different. So these are all compositions, samples of the artwork by color blocking artist Piet Mondrian. Now, I said a keyword, composition. What does the word composition mean? That's what I posed to you guys. What does it mean? Composition. Has anybody ever heard of the word before? Hey, that's pretty good. Okay, somebody basically said a musical composer. Musical composer. Okay, what does a musical composer do? An MC. Musical composer. Okay, oh, they write music. What does that mean? Okay, so, oh, notes. Okay, they put notes on paper. Okay, what do they do with those notes? Ah, you said a key word. Arranging those notes. That's perfect. That's what the word composition means. So have we, is there anything else we've heard, ever heard? That's good. Composition book. What do you do with a composition book? We have one for, okay, yeah. You said science? Yeah, you got one for math, science, maybe other subjects. What do you do with those? You put notes in them. Yeah, you arrange notes, categorize them. So you have your composition book for math, science. Perfect. Same thing. That's what the word composition means. Arrangement. So the whole goal Piet Mondrian was trying to do with his color blocking technique was he was trying to take these things, our list over here, lines, thick, black, vertical, horizontal, colors, primary colors, red, blue, yellow, white, squares, spaces, shapes, rectangles, squares. His whole goal was to take those elements and arrange them, compose them in pieces of art. That's what you're gonna do today. Now before we get started, I wanna ask you, when do you think this artwork by Piet Mondrian was done? All right, hey, that's okay. You think they're very current? Okay, so like maybe 2010? Well, I guess it's 10 years ago. Wow, where does time go? Okay, 1980s. Oh, you said, okay. I think you peeked at the board. These compositions were anywhere between 1930 to the 1940s. So some of these compositions, depending on which ones they were, could be 80, 90 years old. They look contemporary, but really, he was doing this 80 to 90 years ago. All right, guys, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna start doing color blocking art now. All right, so what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be creating your own Piet Mondrian compositions using his rules over here. What you're gonna do, are you're gonna use thick, black, vertical, horizontal lines. Your colors that you're gonna use are gonna be primary colors, red, blue, yellow. You're gonna leave some empty spaces or white boxes. You're gonna have shapes that are only rectangles and squares only in there. Now we're gonna create our own composition in three easy steps. Number one, you're gonna have your ruler, your pencil, and your paper handy. Push the markers aside, we're not gonna need those right now. Number one, you're gonna divide up your areas on your paper. So I have my paper right here on the board, well, it's my trusty whiteboard. I divided up my sections. You want to use your ruler, and you're gonna go ahead and divide up however you want the sections of your paper. Pencil, ruler. Go ahead, pause the video, do so now. Next, the next step is you're gonna use the colors. You're gonna take your colors. Remember, we talked about primary colors. Blue, red, and I'm gonna use black to represent yellow because it's hard to see up on the board. But now what you're gonna do is you're gonna color in those sections. Nice and neat, stay in those lines. Also, I don't wanna see any white. It's about getting that box with that color in there, not seeing any white. So you can choose any squares you want. Go ahead, pause the video, start coloring yours now. All right, so hopefully you divided your sections and you put color to it. Now remember, I want you to color it nice and neat. I just kind of scribbled up on the board for the sake of time. This is my composition right here. Now here's the last step. What I want you to do is you're gonna take your ruler and you're gonna take a black marker. If you don't have a black marker, if you're using crayons, you can take a black crayon or pen, doesn't matter. What you're gonna do now is a lot of students skip ahead and they divide it up real nice. But the one thing they don't do is they don't use their ruler at the end. they go ahead and they just try to freehand those lines. No, we have a ruler for a reason when drawing straight lines. What I want you to do is the last step is you're gonna trace. You're gonna retrace over your black lines nice and neat. And that's gonna make those colors pop, those white squares pop. So go ahead, pause the video, do so now. All right, guys, that concludes this session of Project Sketch here on Map TV. This was the color blocking edition. We talked about the artist Piet Mondrian. You guys did your own compositions. I'm sure they came out great at home. I just wanna show you some examples of some students' artwork that we've had before. If we look here, each one of the students definitely did their own design with doing the same elements of primary colors, thick black lines, white squares, rectangles. They basically did all the elements Piet Mondrian has in his artwork, but they definitely made it their own, which I'm sure you did at home. Remember, you can do this color blocking technique over and over again, just like Piet Mondrian did, doing different compositions. All right, guys, till next time on Project Sketch here on Map TV.